Is your lash growth serum causing long-term damage to your eyes? If you're interested in finding out, keep watching. Aloha everyone, I'm Dr. Rupa, ophthalmologist, and on this channel we talk about eye health, eye surgery, and my favorite topic, eye makeup health. And that's what we're talking about today, lashes and your lash growth serum. Is it causing lasting damage to the skin around your eyes or to the eyes themselves? So just to review, I've got my Latisse here, and then my second favorite, when I was using lash growth serums, and I'm gonna explain why I stopped, but I've got both of them here so we can talk about them. Latisse. Latisse is the only FDA approved lash growth medicine. Basically, they found that when we were using it as an eye drop, and that eye drop was called Lumigan, we noticed that it was causing our patients' lashes to grow really, really long. I had patients that were vets in the Manhattan VA, and you know, these older gentlemen who were not exactly interested in having really long lashes. Like, oh my gosh, your lashes look so good. Anyway, they figured that out in about 2008. They repackaged it into the form Latisse, and basically Latisse is the exact same thing as what's available in Lumigan. The generic name is called bimatoprost, and it is a prostaglandin analog solution. So we found that all of these prostaglandin glaucoma drops were causing lash growth, but you know, this company was the first one to get it to market, and they did all of the FDA trials to show that it actually does cause your lashes to grow longer and thicker. So, what are the side effects that I'm talking about? What could you be doing damage to your eyes by using Latisse every day? So, when we look at the glaucoma drop, the bimatoprost, or even any of the other types of prostaglandin analogs, they're really, really well studied. So we actually know quite well the side effects that they cause. And again, that's when we put the eye drop in the eye, not so much when we're just putting it on the lashes. But what a lot of people do is they put a lot of extra solution on those lash brushes because they just figure more is more. And most of the time it does drip into the eyes. It's pretty hard to put the lash growth serum on the lashes without any of it getting into your eyes at all. So the most benign of those side effects is redness, irritation, and usually those are going to stop as soon as you stop the serum. So those aren't a big deal. Other things that Latisse has been documented to cause is swelling of the inside of the eye. It's called macular edema. It's rare, but it can definitely happen, and that is why this does require a prescription, and typically you want to be following up with your eye doctor just to make sure you don't experience any of these side effects. It's a glaucoma drop that's repackaged, so of course it's going to lower the intraocular pressure of the eye, usually by just a point or two when it's on the lashes themselves, and then when you discontinue the medicine, your pressure will go back up again. But another reason to be checking in with an eye doctor just to make sure that your pressure isn't dangerously low. Really uncommon for that to happen, but possible. And last, it can cause inflammation inside the eye, specific kind of inflammation called uveitis. And we see uveitis in a lot of rheumatologic and infectious type diseases. There's all different ways to manifest uveitis. Uveitis usually will cause floaters, it'll cause decreased vision, light sensitivity. Rare, again, it's a very rare side effect of prostaglandin analogs, but it can happen. So all of these, bimatoprost and Latisse, that is a synthetic prostaglandin. And that prostaglandin is what, they're not exactly sure how, but it does somehow delay the lash cycle and keeps the lash growth phase more active before it cycles on through. So that's how it's thought to work. So that's why when you stop using a lash growth serum, your lashes fall out because they just start going back into that cycle again. Now, uveitis and macular edema are pretty serious things because they can affect your vision and they can cause long-term consequences, but they're pretty rare. Also, a few other things that you'll notice, and I think that's why people get more concerned about some of the other side effects of lash growth serums. So one of them is darkening of the skin around the eye area. Typically, this is temporary, but this has been documented before. And so if you notice that your under eye bags just look like they're getting way worse, you're going to want to stop your lash growth serum. And I say lash growth serum, not just Latisse, because we're going to talk about the other types of lash growth serums in just a second. So skin darkening around the eyes, that's one that is most problematic for us because, hey, you're putting on lashes so that your eyes pop, and then you don't want people looking at your eyes to notice that all of a sudden your under eye bags, your darkening looks really, really, really awful. And then one of the things that they have found in a case report of 7 patients is fat atrophy of the orbital area. So what does that mean? So right around here, this is called your orbit, you have natural fat pads. It's what, you know, cushions your eyeball. When you get older, you start to hollow out. You start to get those, that real shadow effect type. And it's not just skin darkening, but it's actually the hollowing. Some people also call them tear troughs. It's why we inject fillers in this particular area to put a little bit more volume under the eyes. So if you're a cosmetic patient, if you're a patient that's interested in lash growth and this is causing fat atrophy that's irreversible, that's gonna be a problem. So it's permanent fat atrophy. There's no way to reverse those changes. They found 7 patients who had been using the Lumigan eye drop for glaucoma. So not using Latisse for lash growth, but using it inside the eye, found 7 patients that had this fat atrophy. And it's been pretty documented in the literature. So even though Latisse does not say it on the box, it doesn't have it as one of the side effects, I think that it's still very likely that this could happen with Latisse as well. It's the exact same medicine as the Lumigan, and it's the exact same, you know, there's nothing added to it. So it really stands to reason that some of it could be getting in your eye and you could be developing this fat atrophy. So you really need to know that that is a possibility. Because if you're on Latisse and you're not aware of that, that's going to be a big problem because, like I said, it's not reversible. And then the last permanent change is a change in your eye color. And I've done a whole video on do lash serums change your eye color? And that is also another irreversible change. So it's going to change the pigment of people who have a little bit of brown in their eyes. So typically it's going to change hazel or green eyes to more brown. It's not going to change blue eyes to brown. It might even darken brown eyes a little bit more, but it's increasing the melanin that's in your iris. So it's not going to make blue eyes into brown. So you don't need to worry about that. But once that color change happens, again, it's irreversible. So that is with the eye drop being placed in the eye. So those are all the side effects. Those are all things you're going to worry about with Latisse. Does that mean your over-the-counter lash serum is fine? So over-the-counter means you don't need a prescription for it, right? Like the lash serums you go out to the various department stores and the beauty stores and you just buy because it's right there next to the eyeshadow. Does that mean that those are safer than Latisse, like, you know, the lash boost? No. And here's why. So almost all of those lash serums actually have, they've got a lot of different things, and I've also even done another video on that, examining all the ingredients in various different kinds of lash serums. And they've got peptides and biotin and, you know, protein extract and flower extract, all of that stuff. But usually the active ingredient, and you'll find this if you examine the ingredient list, is isopropyl clopidogrel. And what is that? Guess what? It's basically a very similar type prostaglandin analog as bimatoprost, the same thing that's found in Latisse. So the FDA actually issued a warning letter to all of those companies that are selling lash serums with isopropyl clopidogrel. So that's Lash Boost, Grande Lash, New Lash. All of those lash serums have isopropyl clopidogrel in them, and that's a medication. So we don't know what percentage they have of that active ingredient, but more than likely that's what's really causing your lashes to grow. If you're using one of those lash growth serums, it's not the flower extract. Likely it's the isopropyl clopidogrel. So what that means is all of those side effects that I talked about with Latisse, the, you know, the not so bad ones, like the redness and the irritation, the more terrible ones of skin darkening, which is temporary, and then the swelling of the inside of the eye, the uveitis, the macular edema, and then the permanent ones like a change in your eye color and fat atrophy are likely to be possible even with these over-the-counter beauty serums. And then these lash serums can cause or exacerbate dry eyes. So all of this makes it a little bit tough for y'all and for non-eye doctors to understand, because you assume if you're buying something from the beauty counter that it doesn't have a medication in it. So it's probably a little bit startling to realize that it does and that it can have this side effect profile, which is pretty scary. So this is just my education for everybody. If you still love your lash growth serum and you are just willing to take that chance, so be it. I know how wonderful it is to have lashes that look awesome. It is, however, the reason why I've stopped all my lash growth serums, so I have them. They're still full. You've got to make your own choice, but you know at least now what some of the potential risks are. And some of them are temporary, but some are permanent. Anyway, guys, I hope that was helpful. I am not trying to fearmonger or make anyone really nervous or scared, but just trying to educate. And again, y'all make your own decisions about what is best for you and what's best to be putting on your lashes, as long as you have all the information, which sometimes can be really hard to discern from these companies' websites. So let me know what other eye beauty, eye makeup, health topics you are interested in. Drop them in the comments below. I read them all. And until next time, mahalo so much for watching. I don't think people say mahalo so much. I think that's like something I now say. Mahalo for watching. All right, bye.